After his crucifixion, death, and resurrection, Jesus appeared to his disciples alive and conversed with them. Thomas, who was not present at that time, later, when other disciples told him this miracle, doubted and wanted physical proof of the risen Lord. Jesus appeared to them again after 8 days when Thomas was present and said to Thomas, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed," as in John 20:29. After Jesus Christ ascended to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit who lives within us from then on, enabling us to believe that which we do not see with our eyes. The same thought is echoed by Peter, who said about Christ in 1 Peter 1:8-9, "Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not now see him, you believe in him and rejoice with joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory, obtaining the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls." These prove that God wants us to have faith in him without experiencing supernatural occurrences in our lives. A rod in Moses' hands turning into snake, parting of the Red Sea making a dry path at middle of the sea for the Israelites to walk and escape, Elijah raising the widow's dead son to life, and several such supernatural things, and then the amazing miracles done by Jesus Christ, followed by the first century apostles, are all examples of God doing miracles to help the people of weak faith to believe at that point of time. Even Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 14:22 that tongues are not a sign not to them that believe, but to them that believe not. And he reiterated in 1 Corinthians 13:8 that the gift of tongues would cease. Well, though we have the Holy Spirit within us, we can still experience doubt. This, however, does not affect our eternal standing with God. This is because, as in Philippians 1:6, "He who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus." Jesus is the author of perfecter of our faith, says Hebrews 12:2. Faith is the gift of God to his children, and he will mature and perfect it until he returns, says Ephesians 2:8-9. This may be the reason why God is allowing us as Christians to doubt, to make us depend on him through prayer. Sanctification is a process of growing in him, which includes times of doubt and times of great faith. As you mature in Christian life, put your faith in God of the Bible in your everyday situations without looking for supernatural things like miracles, prophetic utterances, faith healings, and tongues.